This small change makes a big difference in the user experience. Imagine different groups of users has their own customized URL to go to the same report, but with the filters on already for them, so they don't have to play around with the filters and wait for the page to load once again. This means the users can actually bookmark the view with the filters already selected, so next time when they need the similar report, they can just click on the link and come back to the same report without having to set anything on the filters. This would make accessing your report much quicker and easy. Hi, welcome. This is SL from the Danalyser. This channel shares tips and tricks to help you build practical reports in Looker Studio. In today's video, I'll guide you on how to create a custom filtered report, and this can all be done in 5 simple steps. If you are interested in elevating your report to the next level, don't forget to watch till the end because I'm going to share some of the bonus tips that's going to help you to improve your user experience. The very first thing we need to do is to enable the custom report URL setting. At the toolbar on top, go to File and select Report Settings. Here at the right hand side, you can see a Report Settings tab and you can scroll down and look for custom bookmark links. Here you can click Enable Viewer Filters in Report Link. If you click on this, you can read that it's actually enable the viewers to save their view settings by adding them to report URL. I'm going to explain more about this in this tutorial. So for now, that is sufficient and you can close this tab. Next, we are going to add a filter control. You can see that I already have my data set up and this is a Google Search Console report, but you can use any data you like. For our example today, I'm going to use country as our filter. After we add the country filter, we're going to select a value and I want you to put your attention to the URL on top when I select. So I'm going to search for United States and click only so that the entire dashboard is going to filter to that value. Now, if you look into the URL, it actually adds a bunch of text here. So this is the custom link that we need. Now we're going to copy this link, paste it in our notes app. So we're going to save this here for our usage later in this tutorial, but you can also just give it away to your users. Once they click the link, they would have the access to what they need straight away without having to alter the filter. Another option is to go to view mode and select the filter again so that you will see the parameters showing up here. Then we can bookmark this page by clicking on this star and name it as United States. Click done. And now when we click on this link, it will help us to filter the entire report without needed to select the country from the dropdown, which is a great time saver. And now I'm going to introduce you the third way, which is to create a button in your report that allows people to navigate to pre-filtered report. Here I'm going to add a text. And here I'm going to say USA. So now I am adding a link to this text box and I'm pasting the link here. I'm not going to select this because I want it to just open on the same tab when the user clicks on it. Now I'm going to view mode and test this out. Oops, doesn't seem like being added here, so I'm adding it once again. Okay, now it's being added and I want to change the color to white. Okay, and go to view mode.
So I've been doing some testing on this feature, but I found that when I select open on the same tab, it doesn't work. Perhaps it's some bug with Looker Studio. So I recommend you to click on the open at a new tab checkbox so that it will work when we click on the link.
As you can see, whenever we filter the report using the custom URL, the users will see this filter control here that they can still select other country if they want. However, sometimes the business prefer not to give so much flexibility and transparency to the users. You would want to move out this filter. So I'm going to go to edit mode, and what you can do is to just drag this filter out of this canvas. So just outside of this white canvas that we have, you can see there's a border here. So just move them out of here.
And the users who only have the view mode access wouldn't be able to filter the country to another region. But I have also noticed that once we move out the filter out of the report, it is rather difficult for the users to kind of know like which country they are in now if they navigate to the page. So my solution would be adding a dynamic title on top of the report. So whenever user filtered to a specific country, the country name would be shown on the title. This would actually be covered in our next tutorial, so make sure to stay tuned for that.
Last but not least, because you stay with me until the end of this video, so I want to give you a bonus tips. We are going to discuss about multiple filter condition. So previously we show a simple example of filtering by via country. In some cases, you might want to have filter for country and another filter for maybe device in our case. Now I'm selecting device equals to tablet and the country equals to United States. And because I want the users to view it from the view mode, so I want to change it to view mode first, then copy this link. And because I already have a link, a bookmark here, so I'm going to just edit this one and paste the link here. All right, so now I'm testing this link out. This is for United States. And this is for United States with the tablet. So what I have just shown you is that this report URL is very flexible and versatile, as it not only allows you to filter your report by one condition, but you can have a few criteria.
So that's all about the learnings today. I hope you enjoyed it. In our next tutorial, we're going to learn how to generate all these links automatically using just some tweak around the formulas, so you don't have to do it manually, because sometimes we want to generate like thousands of links. That would be very time consuming if you did it using today's method. But today's method do give you a very good flexibility and in terms of how you want to filter the report. So the choice is up to you. I'm going to give you both the methods so you can do the decision yourself. So if you are excited for that, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and ring the notification bell so you get notified when the video is up. So see you next time. Bye bye. Plus, if there's any new request for adding more charts, you can just edit this one page and have all the regional reports updated instantly.
Technically, if they know how to edit this URL, they can still access the report, but in most cases the end users won't have the expertise to do that. So I think this is something that worth mentioning, because if you were to use it for different clients, external clients I mean, then it wouldn't be a good idea to use the parameters to filter your report, because there are still chances that your client might be able to see other clients of yours
data.